The Consumer Action Law Centre is calling for urgent changes to what it says are procedural failings in the state's magistrates' courts. A new report sheds light on the 40,000 Victorians who have default judgments recorded against them each year when they fail to lodge a defence in court. The report calls on the courts to make changes to protect the most vulnerable members of the community. Here's Consumer Affairs reporter Amy Bainbridge.
Susan Tran's bills have been piling up. As a single mother, she's the sole carer for her two autistic sons and owes a credit company $8,000. Last year she received a default judgment, which is automatically recorded against someone who fails to defend their case. She says caring for her boys meant she couldn't attend court and she struggles to get any help at all.
I've got the disability kids and it's very hard to go into any office and ask for help.
Ms Tran's home is on the market and she's unsure of her future.
I feel like I'm by myself and, you know, what I do if I lost my home, you know, where are we going to live?
Susan Tran's case is among the 80% of debt cases that go undefended in the state's magistrates' courts. Most are for amounts under $10,000 and most are against people in areas of high disadvantage.
Often tales of family breakdown, illness, mental health problems, ongoing receipt of income support, so people on very low incomes who are vulnerable.
If a default judgment is entered against someone, it means it will be a mark on their credit report and they'll be vulnerable to other harsher enforcement procedures such as garnishing wages, seizing of assets, including the family home.
The Consumer Action Law Centre says the courts could be doing more to help vulnerable people avoid default judgments. It says there's more scope to link them up with early intervention services or to set up payment plans rather than recording an automatic black mark against someone's name.
The ABC contacted the Melbourne Magistrates Court, but the Chief Magistrate was not available to comment. The government says it's a matter for the courts. Amy Bainbridge, ABC News, Melbourne.